short, every other president for those 12 things. They're very good gifts, can give her a plaque, I'm providing us some plaques, a ball of purity, and save ourselves a good one. Holy God, holy mighty, holy more flowers, yes. Holy God, holy mighty, holy more flowers, yes. Holy God, holy mighty, holy more flowers, yes. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages, amen. All those holy friends, together, stand us, O Lord, wash away our sins, O Master, pardon our iniquities, O Holy One, visit and heal our infirmities for thy name's sake. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages, amen. Our Father, Lord, in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one.
For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and on ever and under ages of the ancient earth.
Amen. Lord have mercy, 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 Lord have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages, amen. Come, let us worship God, our King. Come, let us worship and fall down before Christ, our King and God. Come, let us worship and fall down before Christ himself, our King and our God. Hearken, O Lord, unto my righteousness, attend unto my supplication, give ear unto my prayer, which cometh not from deceitful lips. From before thy face let my judgment come forth, let mine eyes behold uprightness. Thou hast proved my heart, thou hast visited it in the night, thou hast tried me by fire, and righteousness was not found in thee. That my mouth might not speak of the works of men for the sake of the words of others, that I kept the ways that are hard. Set my footsteps in thy paths, that my steps may not be shaken. I have cried, for thou hast hearkened unto me, O God. Incline thine ear unto me, and hearken unto my words. Let thy mercy be made wonderful, O thou that savest them that hope in thee. From them that have resisted thy right hand, keep me, O Lord, as the apple of thine eye. The shelter of thy wings, O thou shalt be from the face of thee, O God, which oppressed me. My enemies have surrounded my soul, they have enclosed themselves with their own fat. Their mouth has spoken pride. They that cast me out have now encircled me, and they have set their eyes with a chance on the earth. They have taken me as my line, ready for his prey, and as my line, both that dwell in hiding. Arise, O Lord, overtake them, and truth their heels, deliver my soul from ungodly men. Thy sword from the enemies of thy hand, O Lord, from thy feet, do thou separate them from the earth and their life. Yea, with thy hidden treasures hath their belly been filled. They have satisfied themselves with swine, and have left the remnants to their babes. But as for me, in righteousness shall I appear before thy face. I shall be filled when thy glory is made manifest unto me. Unto thee, O Lord, have I lifted up my soul. O my God, in thee have I trusted. Let me never be put to shame, nor let mine enemies laugh me to scorn. Yea, let none that wait on me be put to shame. Let them be ashamed which are lawless without a cause. Make thy ways, O Lord, known unto me, and teach me thy paths. Lead me in thy truth, and teach me, for thou art God, my Savior. For on thee have I waited all the day long. Remember thy compassion, O Lord, and thy mercies, for they are everlasting. The sins of my youth and my ignorance, and remember not. According to thy mercy, remember thou me, for the sake of thy goodness, O Lord. Good and upright is the Lord, therefore will he set a law for them that sin in the way. He will guide the meek in judgment, he will teach the meek his ways. All the ways of the Lord are mercy and truth unto them that seek after his covenant and his testimonies. For the sake of thy name, O Lord, be gracious unto my sin, for it is great. Who is the man that feareth the Lord, who will set him a law in the way in which he hath chosen? His soul shall dwell in the good things, and his feet shall inherit the earth. The Lord is the strength of them that fear him, and his covenant shall be manifested unto them. Mine eyes are ever toward the Lord, for he it is that will draw my feet out of the snare. Look upon me and have mercy on me, for I have one only begotten, for the afflictions of my heart multiply and bring me out from my necessities. Behold my lowliness and my toil, and forgive all my sins. Look upon mine enemies, for they are multiplied. With an unjust hatred have they hated me. Keep my soul and rescue me, and let me not be put to shame, for I have looked to thee. The innocent and the upright have cleaved unto me, for I have waited on thee, O Lord. Redeem Israel, O God, out of all his afflictions. Have mercy on me, O God, according to thy great mercy, and according to the multitude of thy compassions. Blot out my transgression. Wash me thoroughly from my iniquity, and cleanse me from my sin. For I know my iniquity, and my sin is ever mountains, be justified in thy words, and prevail in thou art judge. Behold, thou hast conceived iniquities and sins in my mother's bosom. For behold, thou lovest truth, the hidden and secret things, and thou wisdom thou hast made manifest unto me. Thou shalt sprinkle me with hyssop, and I shall be made clean. Thou shalt wash me, and I shall be made whiter than snow. Thou shalt make me to enjoy gladness, the bones that have been humbled, they shall rejoice. Turn thy face from my sins, and blot out all my iniquities, create in me a clean heart, O God, and a quiet spirit within me. Cast me not away from thy presence, and take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation, and with thy heavenly spirit establish me. I shall teach transgressors thy ways, and you, God, they shall turn back unto thee. Deliver me from all guiltiness, O God, O God, my salvation. My tongue shall rejoice in thy righteousness. O Lord, thou shalt open my lips, and my mouth shall declare thy praise, for thou hast desired sacrifice unto me. With bulls and offerings thou shalt not be pleased. The sacrifice unto God is a broken spirit, a heart that is broken and humbled, God will not despise. Do good, O Lord, and thy good pleasure, and whose sign, and let the walls of Jerusalem be built. Then thou wilt be pleased with the sacrifice of righteousness, with oblation and bulls and offerings, and the shame of the offerings upon thine altar. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to the end of the ages. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. When the stone had been sealed by the Jews, while the soldiers were guarding him, most pure body, thou didst rise on the third day, O Savior, granting life to the world. The powers of heaven know it will cry to thee, O giver of life. Glory to thy resurrection, O Christ. Glory to thy kingdom. Glory to thy dispensation, O thou who lovest mankind. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. In giving birth, thou didst preserve thy virginity. In falling asleep, thou didst not forsake the world of Theotokos. Thou wast translated into life, O mother of life, and by thy prayers thou dost deliver our souls from death. Both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. O Theotokos, thou art the true vine that hath blossomed forth for us the fruit of life. Thee we supplicate, intercede, O Lady, together with all the apostles, that our souls find mercy. Blessed is the Lord God, blessed is the Lord day by day, the God of our salvation shall prosper us along the way. Our God is the God of salvation. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. O most holy Trinity, have mercy on us, O Lord, blot out our sins, and ask for pardon our iniquities. O Holy One, visit and heal our infirmities for thy sins. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in the heavens, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil. Thank you.
We may think we have good things and all of them are from the glory and blessed are thou, who is the King of Time. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, to the ages of ages. Amen. For honorable then the sheriff with the honor of the ceremony, glorious God the ceremony, who without corruption gave his mercy to God the Word, the very fails of most of the human act of fire, in the name of the Lord, Father, bless.
The prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, and our God.
Amen. God, the Father Almighty, O Lord, the only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit, one God, that one power, have mercy on me, a sinner, by the judgments which thou knowest, save me, God, and give us the blessed art thou, who gave us the face of heaven. Come, let us worship God, our King. Come, let us worship and fall down before Christ, our King and God. Come, let us worship and fall down before Christ himself, our King and God. O God, in thy name, save me, and in thy strength, be thou judging me, O God, our King and God, my prayer, and the hearing of the words of my mouth. Strength is your wisdom against me, and my enemies caught up in my soul, and have not set God before themselves. For behold, God, often me, O Lord, is the protector of my soul, and he will bring evils upon my enemies. Utterly destroy them by thy hand, and willingly will I sacrifice them to thee, O God, that thy name, O Lord, for it is good. For I have every affliction as thou delivered me, and mine eye hath looked down upon my enemies. See me, O God, in my prayer, and sustain not my supplication, and have this to me, and hear me. I was grieved in my meditation, I was troubled at the voice of the enemy, and at the oppression of the sinner, because they have turned iniquity upon me, and wrath for the angry against me. My heart is troubled within me, the terror of death has fallen upon me, fear and trembling are come upon me, and darkness hath covered me, and I said, who will give me wings like a dove, and I will fly and be at rest. Though I have fled far on, and as well from the wilderness, I waited for God to save me from favor and blessing from heaven. Plunge them into the depths of the Lord, and fly their tongues, for I have seen the iniquity and gainsaying of the city. Day and night they go round about and on the walls, and the iniquity is flowing, and unrighteousness are in the midst of her. And he was greatly seen, and not departed from the streets. For if my enemy ever bowed me, and I should burn him, and she had hated me, had spoken boastful words against me, I might have hid myself from him. But thou it was, a man of like soul, to be my guide and my familiar friend. Thou who together with me did sweep my paths in the house of God, I walked with thee, and let us upon thee. Let death come upon them at once, and let them go down alive in cage, for wickedness is in their dwellings and in the midst of them. As for me and the God, I cry, and the Lord hearken unto me. Evening, morning, and noonday will I tell them, and will be better, and he will hear my voice. He will redeem my soul in peace from them that brought nigh unto me, for they among many were with me. God will hear and will humble them, who said to be questioned his mercy, that there is no requital, because they have not heard of God. He has stretched forth his hand in retribution, they have defiled his covenant, they were scattered by the wrath of his countenance, and the cross of his feet. Their words were smoother than oil, and yet they are darts cast by care upon the Lord, and he will nourish thee. He will never permit the righteous to be shaken. But thou, O God, shall bring those men down in the pit of destruction. Bloody and deceitful men shall not look out after days, but as for me, O Lord, I will hope in thee. He that dwelleth in the help of the Most High shall abide the shelter of the God of heaven. He shall say unto the Lord, thou art my helper and my refuge. He is my God, and I will trust in thee, for he shall deliver thee from the snare of the hunters and from every troubling work. With his shoulders will he overshadow thee, and under his wings shalt thou have hope. With a shield will his truth encompass thee. Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flieth by day, nor for the thing that walketh in darkness, nor for the mishap of even of noonday. A thousand shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand. But unto thee shall it not come nigh, only with thine eye shalt thou behold, and thou shalt see the reward of sinners. For thou, O Lord, art my hope. Thou madest the Most High thy refuge. No evil people shall come nigh thee, and no scourge shall draw nigh into thy dwelling. For he shall give his angels charge over thee, keep thee in all thy ways. On their hands shall they bear thee up, lest at any time thou dash thy foot against the stone. Upon the asp and the basilisk shalt thou tread, and thou shalt trample upon the lion and the dragon. For he hath set his hope on thee, and I will deliver him. I will shelter him, because he hath known my name. He shall cry unto me, and I will hearken unto him. I am with him in affliction, and I will rescue him and glorify him. With length of days will I satisfy him, and I will show him my salvation. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now Thomas. Hallelujah, glory to God. Lord of mercy. When the stone had been sealed by the Jews, while the soldiers were guarding them, most of your body, now it's rise on the third day, O Savior, granting life to the world, the powers of heaven, therefore cry to thee, O giver of life. Glory to thy resurrection, O Christ. Glory to thy kingdom. Glory to thy dispensation, O thou who lovest mankind. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Holy Apostle, Thaddeus, and chief and merciful God, who grant our souls forgiveness of transgressions, both now and ever, and in the ages of ages. Amen. Seeing that you have the boldness on account of our many sins, we have deceived him that we want to be a day of levels, for the supplication of the Mother of Ella, and blessing in the Master's favor, to stain up the prayers of sinners, all here which for merciful and mighty to save us, that you may also suffer for our sake. Let thy compassions quickly go before us, O Lord, so we are becoming exceedingly poor. Help us, O God, our Savior, to the state of the glory of thy name, O Lord. Deliver us, be gracious unto thy sins, for thy name's sake. Holy God, holy mighty, holy mortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy mortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy mortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, Lord of the heavens, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one.
For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen. Neither the tomb nor death could hold the veil of those who is constant in prayer and our firm hope in her intercessions. For being the mother of life, she was translated to life by the one who dwelt in her virtual womb. Holy and good and life-creating spirit, now and ever, to the ages of ages. Master, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, source of life and immortality, creator of all things visible and invisible, the co-eternal and co-unwritten Son of the unwritten Father, who out of thy great goodness didst in the latter days clothe thyself in flesh, and was crucified and buried for us ungrateful and evil disposed, and cast being into the ground of all our sin and corrupted us. Do thou thyself, O Lord, being accepted in repentance and be a sinner, and mind on your duty and heart and entitlement. For I have sinned against heaven before thee, and I have not heard and looked upon the high thy words. For I have angered thy goodness by transgressing thy commandments, and not of any kind of judgment. But thou, O Lord, who art not vengeful, but long-suffering, and plenteous in mercy, hast not given me over to be destroyed with my sins, but always thou bringest my feet to conversion. For thou hast said, deliver mankind through thy power. For I desire not the death of sinners, that he should return. For thou desirest not a master to destroy the work of thy hands, neither shalt thou be pleased with the destruction of men. But desirest that all be saved from the knowledge of the truth. Wherefore even I, although unworthy of heaven and earth, and of this temporal life, having submitted my whole self to sin and made myself the slave of pleasure, and having defaced thine image, yet gained thy work of creation, wretched though I be, I despair not of my salvation, and dare to approach thy pleasure of loving kindness. Except that even you, O Lord, Lover of mankind, as thou hast accepted the sinful woman, the thief, and take away the heavy burden of my sin. Thou that takest away the sin of the world and healest the infirmities of mankind, callest the weary and heavy laden unto thyself and givest them rest. Who camest not to call the righteous but sinners to repentance. And do thou cleanse me from all defilement of flesh and spirit, and be filled with new holiness and purity. That with the pure testimony of my conscience, receiving the portion of thy holy things, I may be united unto thy holy body and blood, and happy living and abiding in thee with the Father and thy Holy Spirit. Yea, O Lord Jesus Christ, my God, let not the communion of thine immaculate and life-giving mystery be unto me for judgment, neither unto the infirmity of soul and body, because of my partaking of them adorably, but grant me until my last breath to receive without condemnation the portion of thy holy things, and to communion with the Holy Spirit as a provision for life eternal, for an acceptable defense of thy great judgment seat, so that I also with all thine elect may become a partaker of thy incorruptible blessing, thou hast prepared for them who love thee, O Lord, in whom thou art glorified unto the ages. Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Presence and the sons of men in the land. the glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and until the end of ages.
Yeah.
You said of glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever.
O Lord, save the fire. Unto the world, both to angels and to men. We are fools for Christ's sake, but you are wise in Christ. We are weak, but you are strong. You are honored, but we are despised. To the present hour, we both hunger and thirst. We are naked and beaten and homeless, and we labor, working with our own hands. Being reviled, we bless. Being persecuted, we endure. Being defamed, we entreat. We have been made as the filth of the world, and are the offscouring of all things unto this day. I do not write these things to shame you, but as my beloved sons, I warn you. For though you have 10,000 instructors in Christ, yet you do not have many fathers. For in Christ Jesus I have begotten you through the gospel.
Therefore I beseech you to follow me.
Peace be unto you, reader.
And to thy spirit.
Wisdom.
In the first tone, alleluia, 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 God gives vengeance unto me and subdues people under me. Of the king and deals mercifully with David, his anointed, and his seed forever.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
In the eighth tone, arise, O Lord, into thy rest, thou in the ark of thy sanctification.
Disciples. And at that time, it was regarding the feeding of the 5,000 people, where Jesus tells his disciples, you know, you give them something to eat. You only have 5 loaves and 2 fish, but I want you to feed all these people. And the disciples, you know, were obedient. And of course, they then took part in this great miracle. But just a chapter later, we read that they were faced with another situation where they had to feed 4,000 more people. And the disciples come running to Jesus and they were saying, where are we going to get enough food? So apparently they didn't quite learn that lesson well enough. But, you know, the disciples, like all of us, were faithful at times. And at other times, they were weak. That's just all a part of spiritual growth, right? Well, today's gospel lesson, we have another incident where the disciples' faith is tested. And this poor demon, the boy who was being, tortured by these demons, and they were helpless at being able to deal with it, to cast out these demons. And, you know, just like a little while before that, they had been bragging about how, well, even the demons are subject to us, you know. And in this case, yet they were helpless, and they come to Jesus and say, well, why? You know, we cast out demons before. Why could we not do it again? And Jesus said, your faith is because of your lack of faith. You know, faith is not something that's static. It really is, it's dynamic. It has to be renewed every day. Just because we're faithful today doesn't guarantee that we're going to be faithful tomorrow. We all know this, right? And so it's something that we need to continually renew our faith in Christ every day. The disciples in this case had apparently taken for granted the power given to them, or they had come to believe that it was inherent within them. They neglected to realize that the source of their power was in Christ. Their lack of faith indicated they had forgotten that their power over the demonic spirits was from Jesus. It kind of reminds me of this other incident we read about in the book of Acts, about these itinerant exorcists, you know, who were, so some of the itinerant Jewish exorcists took it upon themselves to call the name of the Lord Jesus over those who had evil spirits, saying, we exorcise you by the Jesus whom Paul preaches. And the evil spirit answered and said, Jesus I know, Paul I know, but who are you? And then the man in whom the evil spirit leaped on them, overpowered them, and prevailed against them, so that they fled out of the house naked and wounded. So it didn't go so well for them. Again, because they thought that the power was within themselves, forgetting that it was that any power that we have only comes from Jesus. Jesus doesn't, this is not magic, okay? We recognize that in the source of any power or strength that we have, that it's not something that comes from ourselves, but it comes from the Lord through faith. And Jesus does give us a couple of very practical ways that we can strengthen our faith, that we can access his grace in our life. And this is nothing new, brothers and sisters. It's what we hear all the time. It's prayer and fasting. That's what Jesus says to the disciples. These don't come out except by prayer and fasting. Now, we can identify with the disciples in the current challenges we face. We may feel helpless in the midst of the turmoil in our world, or the problems within our own life, troubles that we face. People respond in different ways: anger, fear, denial, hopelessness, rebellion, throwing caution to the wind. Well, what about prayer and fasting, right? Why is this not our response? Don't we believe that Jesus is sovereign over all creation? That whatever turmoil there is in the world, whatever troubles we face in our life, that he is sovereign over that? Do we have that kind of faith? Whatever problems we face, God gives us the opportunity to repent, to seek the Lord's help through prayer and fasting. You know, some time ago I was kind of helping a friend or counseling a friend who was in a really dark place, and he was having some real troubles and was in a tough spot. And he was, you know, kind of bemoaning all these things that he was going through. And I said to him, you know, have you prayed about this? And his response was, wow, has it come to that? And I said, brother, it came to that a long time ago. You know, why do we think that prayer is always our last resort when it really should be our first resort? The prophet Micah says, if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven and heal their land. You know, we Christians often complain about, you know, the restrictions on the church and whatever that we're facing in our society today. But you know what there are no restrictions on? Prayer and fasting. No restrictions on that. We can pray and we can fast as much as we want. This is how we strengthen and exercise our faith. And one other thing is necessary. We hear in the liturgy just before communion, you know, with faith and love draw near, right? In the fear of God, with faith and love draw near. And so love also is very important. In fact, St. Paul says in 1 Corinthians 13, a chapter I'm sure we're all familiar with, though I have the gift of prophecy and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and though I have all faith so that I could remove mountains, but have not love, I am nothing. So faith, prayer, combined with love, that is the strength. That is the best way to access God's power. If we pray and treat others with love, that's how we exercise our faith. Now, do we believe that God answers prayer? I believe that God answers prayer. It may not always be the answer we want, but God does hear our prayers if we're praying in sincerity. Some years ago, I read this article about this, it was a small town, a very small town, somewhere in the Midwest, I can't remember exactly. But this town had no bars or nightclubs until one time this businessman came and he bought a place right on Main Street in town and he turned it into a bar, you know, tavern, nightclub. And the Christians in that town were pretty upset by this. And there was one congregation that began a prayer crusade on this issue. And they got people together and they prayed, you know, that this bar would not, you know, be able to open. Well, the bar did open, but they were praying that somehow God would deal with it, right? In fact, they would have groups of people that would stand outside of the bar and pray that it would close, you know, that somehow God would intervene and it would close. Well, after some time, one night, lightning struck the bar. Now, thankfully, nobody was, you know, injured or hurt, but it destroyed them. Basically, the bar burned to the ground. And the bar owner sued the congregation, took them to court, claiming that it was because of their prayers that he lost his business. Now, what do you think the church did? You think they rejoiced and thanked God that their prayers were answered? No, they hired a lawyer to fight the charges. And it's interesting, the judge in his decision said, wherever the guilt may lie, it was obviously the tavern keeper, not the church, who really believed in the power of prayer. So do we believe God answers prayer? Well, if we do, when we pray, we better act on that and accept whatever answer that God is going to give. The terms prayer and fasting have become kind of a part of the popular the lexicon of our day. You know, we hear a lot about thoughts and prayers in response to some tragedy. And that's fine. That's good. If we are actually praying. But let's not just say, you know, use the word prayer to indicate our concern for something. If we're going to say we're going to pray for something, then we should actually do it and not just, you know, use the expression thoughts and prayers. Prayer is not just a term to show that we're concerned. Neither is prayer a list of our needs and wishes that we are asking God to rubber stamp. St. Paul says that with prayer and supplications, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. Well, but always with the caveat, Lord, it's your will, not mine. Your will, not mine, be done. So yes, we do pray. We, And with thanksgiving, we do pray and let our request be made known, but understanding that our prayer is we're putting ourselves basically, you know, in God's hands and just saying it's your will that is to be done. And then now with regard to fasting. I've recently read some articles about the health benefits of intermittent fasting. Have you heard about this? Intermittent fasting. And it's, you know, the way it's described, it's almost like some sort of a health plan or a diet plan, right? And while I'm sure that it may be true that fasting is good for our physical health, these articles totally ignore the spiritual benefits of fasting. As one writer put it, Jesus did not tell us to fast so that you could fit into your skinny jeans. Fasting is a spiritual discipline above all. Prayer and fasting are these disciplines that God gives to strengthen our faith and enable us to access His grace in our lives. We're not likely to face the same kind of dramatic demonic experience that the disciples faced in this account. But whatever demons that we're battling in our lives, anger, envy, gluttony, greed, lust, pride, sloth, whatever it is, those can only be dealt with through prayer and fasting. We can only have victory over these things in our lives if we are committed to prayer and fasting as spiritual disciplines. St. Paul tells us to be strong in the Lord. And one of the ways that we are strong in the Lord is being dedicated to prayer and fasting. In Ephesians he writes, "Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of His might. Put on the whole armor of God that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. Praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, being watchful to this end with all perseverance and supplication for all the saints." Brothers and sisters, let us persevere. Never give up. Don't give up hope. Don't become faint. But persevere in prayer and fasting. And we will see God's work in our life. If we do this. Christ is in our midst.
Calistos, Dorothea, Elena, Linda, Archpriest David and Alice, Archpriest Anthony, St. Silouan Mission, Deacon Joseph, Deacon Seraphim, and Susan, Petuska Priscilla, Monk Ignatius, Ruth, Joanne, Catherine, Linda, Karen, Alexandra, Jean, Cheryl, Marie, Louis Andrew, Michaela, Curtis, Anne, Ron, Mary Lou, Kent, Olga, Jamie, Gregory, Catherine, Bob, Susan, Elena, Monica, Paul, Carol, Jean, Melinda, Helen, Theodosius, Thomas, Clark, Grace, Eugene, Anna, newly born Olympia, those suffering in Ukraine and refugees, with child Anna, Amelia, Caitlin, Elizabeth, Tabitha, Vera, and for the brethren of this holy temple, and for the pardon and remission of their sins.
Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy.
Again, we pray for those who bring offerings and do good works in this holy and all venerable temple, for those who labor and those who sing, for all the people here present who await that great and rich mercy.
Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy.
For thou art a merciful God and love mankind, and unto thee do we send up glory, to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
The Lord, ye catechumens. Let us, the faithful, pray for the catechumens, that the Lord may have mercy on them, that he may teach them the word of truth, that he may reveal to them the gospel of righteousness, that he may send for the holy catechism of the Catholic Church, save them. Depart, let no catechumen remain. Let us, the faithful, again and again in peace, pray unto the Lord.
Lord,
help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, thank you.
America and Canada. May the Lord our God remember his kingdom always, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. The most reverend Benjamin, Archbishop of San Francisco in the West, may the Lord our God remember his kingdom always, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
All those in priestly and monastic orders, may the Lord our God remember them in his heavenly kingdom, always, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
May the Lord our God remember in his kingdom the president of our country, all those in law enforcement and civil authority, always, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
The newly departed servants of God, especially the Marcus Kahana, may the Lord God remember his kingdom always, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. The ill and suffering servants of God, the servant of God, Chad Ron, who is recovering from surgery, the servant Elena, who is preparing for surgery this week. May the Lord God remember his kingdom always, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. All those Christians who are suffering from the persecution of the faith throughout the world, may the Lord God remember his kingdom always, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. The founders and benefactors of this holy house, those who labor and those who sing, those who love us and those who hate us, may the Lord God remember his kingdom always, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. You and all Orthodox Christians, may the Lord God remember his kingdom always, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Glorious Lady Theotokos and and ever Virgin Mary with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
Amen.
shouting and proclaiming and singing.
Holy,
thank you.
Keith Hunter, Archbishop Benjamin, grant that for their holy churches in peace, safety, honor, health, and length of days, right to be divine, the word of thy truth. Captives in their salvation. Remember, O Lord, those who have been offered to do good in thy holy churches, those who are under the poor, and upon all that stand forth thy great mercy. I grant that with one mouth and one heart, we may praise thy all honorable and majestic name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
To the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the precious gifts now offered and sanctified, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O God, who loves mankind, having received him upon his holy and noetic altar, above the heavens as a sweet spiritual fragrance, will send down upon us in return his divine grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray.
Lord, have mercy.
That we may be delivered from all affliction, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
That the whole day may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant us, O Lord.
An angel of peace, a faithful guide, a guard of our souls and bodies, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant us, O Lord.
Pardon the remission of our sins and transgressions, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant us, O Lord.
All things that are good and profitable for our souls and peace for the world, let us ask of the Lord. In peace and repentance, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant us, O Lord.
Make an ending to our life, painless, blameless, and peaceful, and a good defense before the dread judgment seat of Christ, let us ask.
Grant us, O Lord.
Having asked for the unity, the faith, and the communion of the Holy Spirit, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
And make us worthy, O Master, that with boldness and without condemnation, you may dare to call on me, the heavenly God, as Father, and to save you.
Thank you.
through the grace and compassion of our Lord, mankind, and the only begotten Son, with whom are blessed together with thine only good and life-giving Spirit, now and ever in the ages of ages.
Right. Thank you.
Lamb of Christ, having partaken of the divine, holy, most pure, immortal, heavenly, life-giving, and dreadful streets of Christ, let us worthily give thanks unto the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us.
Give peace to thy world, to thy churches, to thy priests, to all those in civil authority, to the armed forces, and to all thy people. For every good gift and every perfect gift is from above, coming down from thee, the Father of lights, and unto thee do we send up glory, thanksgiving, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Of America.
First of all, I want to thank our substitute choir director today. He did a wonderful job, didn't he? All those years at seminary, you know? There we go. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Brian. Father Timothy, as you know, is away on vacation, but please pray for he and Joni. I believe they were either at the monastery this Sunday or at Calistoga, but one way or the other, please keep him in your prayers, and he will be back this coming week. As far as the schedule goes, on Wednesday the 24th, we have Vespers at 6, and then on the 25th, 9 a.m. Matins and choir rehearsal at 6 p.m. on Thursday evening, and then the regular cycle.
6:30.
Oh, it says 6 here. 6:30. I noticed that next Sunday there's going to be a development committee meeting, so that's important to keep in mind. Please, if you would, remember Ron Garner. Remember we were saying Ron was going to have surgery last week? Well, he did. A new valve, a heart valve put in. It's amazing how they do that today, you know. And he's doing quite well. He's recovering very well. So keep him in your prayers, and Ron, if you would. I found out last night that Leni Klefka is in the hospital and in Kaiser Roseville, and it looks as though she's scheduled to have a gallbladder removal. Do I have this right, Vicki?
Yes.
On next Tuesday or Wednesday of Tuesday or Wednesday of next week. So please keep her in your prayers if you would. Metropolitan Kalistos Ware, you know, whom we've known for many, many years. In fact, I even have a photo of him sitting with or standing with a group of parishioners when we all went to a talk he gave in San Francisco many, many years ago. But by all accounts, he's suffering and near death, so please keep him in your prayers if you would. The only other thing I have to mention that's of worth, well, somewhat of worth, is that yesterday was Father Tom's 74th birthday.
No way.
Yes. Where is he? Where is that young man? There he is. Now, you know, you all know this story. It's kind of a joke. It's been around for a long time about the three stages of life. Have you heard this one?
Yes.
There are three stages of life. There are three stages of life. There is youth. You know, someone like Ezekiel here, he's even younger than you. There's middle age, like Father Steve and myself. And then there's you're looking good. So Father Tom is going to be holding the cross today, and after you venerate the cross, not before, properly, you know, doing all of that properly, venerate the cross, kiss the priest's hand, and all of that's done, you know, your devotion is done, then you can say to Father Tom, you're looking good.
I thought the last stage was, what did I come in here for? Where I am.
Anything else? Any other announcements?
Father, there is Old Testament Bible study today after coffee hour, so please come Tobit or not Tobit.
All right. Yeah.
I have one small item. Thank you very much for all those people that bring recycling to our little yard. On the left as you go in is pre-sorted. I've sorted through, got the cans and bottles separated. So if you bring stuff, if you wouldn't mind putting it to the right so that I know that it needs to be gone through. Thank you so much.
Can I add something to that? Since I do the bottles, please take the caps off the bottles first. And get rid of them, they're not glass, so they can't go with the glass.
Very good.
Whether they're plastic or metal.
Yeah, thank you both for doing that. Okay, Deacon Joseph.
Yes.
For many years.
On the 21st, we have a birthday, Ethan Kellogg. On the 22nd, Candy Koss Herbert has a birthday. On the 24th, Adia Dubovic has a birthday. On the 25th, David Dean has a birthday. Also, same day, John Valicio has a birthday, and likewise, Matthew Hutchison has a birthday. On the 25th, Peter Buha has a birthday. On the 26th, Natalie Walker has a names day. Natalia Cedarborg has a names day. On the 27th, Devin Christopher Letson has a names day. Anybody else who would like to keep remembering?
My niece Gina.
On the 24th, okay. Anybody else? Okay, good.
Who reign, O Lord, a prosperous, peaceful life, health and salvation and furtherance in all blessed things upon thy servants, Ethan, Andy, Claudia, David, John, Matthew, Peter, Natalie, Talia, Devin, Dina, and preserve them for many years.
Go in peace. May the blessings of the Lord.